Hi guys, Nick Jennison from Guitar Interactive, and on the test bench today we're taking a look at the MVJ4-66 from Modern Vintage. And as the name would suggest, this is a modernized take on a vintage J style bass. Now we're not going to say the J word in question, because when you put it with bass, that is a trademarked term, but you all know what I'm talking about. Now the body contours, the looks, the sounds are all vintage correct. We even have this pickup cover and thumb rest as you'd expect from a 66 J bass, but it has some crucial modern updates that improve stability, playability, reliability, and all the other abilities. Now, in the intro, you heard us playing with both pickups full up. We're going to explore all the different tones in a moment, but before we do that, let's talk about the specifications, beginning at the headstock end. So starting at the headstock, the first thing you'll notice is the painted head cap. Now this is sometimes offered as an expensive upgrade on some basses, comes as standard here, it really looks very attractive. I like the headstock shape too. Again, it is a modern take on that classic vintage design. There's no real kind of gaudy adornments going on here. We have a single string retainer, four in a line tuners, and I'm gonna flip it over and show you the back. These are hip shots, lightweight, open gear, lollipop style tuners. They feel great, the gearing is super smooth, and like I say, they're lightweight, which is gonna keep the weight of the instrument down and also prevent any neck dive. And now that we're back here, we can also get a look at the heat treated maple neck. Now it is your typical slim J style profile, very comfortable to play, and it's been plecked from the factory, so it feels absolutely tremendous, plays really beautifully. We're gonna flip it back over and take a look at the nut. We have a 37 millimeter nut spacing, an Indian rosewood fretboard, and we have white binding all the way across the neck with frets over the top of the binding, which looks very attractive. We've got small dot markers, so there's no big gaudy crazy inlays or any of this sort of stuff. It's very much a vintage looking bass, which is really nice in my book. I like the way these sort of instruments look. We're going to turn our attention down to the body real quick. Again, you can see the Olympic white finish is already picking up some of my beard hairs, but even still, looks absolutely tremendous. It's going to look great on stage lights. Looks pretty at home in pretty much any musical setting. Now, some of the things that are going to divide opinion here are going to be the pickup cover and the thumb rest. You can, of course, remove these, but they do come as standard, as you'd expect, on a vintage style bass. But one thing that is interesting is the truss rod adjustment hole here, which is going to give you easy access to the truss rod should you need to adjust it. Now, because the maple neck is heat treated and has had the moisture removed from it, it should be more stable than a typical maple neck. But even still, if you do need to adjust the rod for whatever reason, it's really easy to get to, which is not something you can say on many vintage basses. Also, I should point out as well, it's a 34 inch scale, as you would expect from this type of bass. That's pretty standard, and it also has a period correct alder body and weighs in at 9 pounds 13 ounces. So it's not a featherweight, but it's definitely not heavy bass by any stretch of the imagination. Now there are two J style pickups down here, which are controlled by a volume for each pickup and a master tone. We're going to explore these in a second. We'll get to that in just a moment, but there's no active electronics, there's no fancy switching, no series parallel switches. It is very much vintage correct when it comes to the tones, and all of the modern appointments are really more down to playability and stability. We also have these steel saddles, as you'd expect on a 66 J bass, which is what this instrument is based on. Now let's take a listen to some more tones, and we're going to focus our attention on the blend of pickups that are available using these two volumes. We're going to start with the bridge pickup on its own, and then I'm going to blend the neck pickup in one quarter turn at a time until we are up full with both volumes. Then we'll blend the bridge pickup out one quarter turn at a time. Let's take a listen to that now. Thank you. So now we've heard the blends that you can get out of these two pickups, let's do some more specific examples. Starting with more fingerstyle, and we're gonna do some soloing type playing, maybe with some harmonics and some kind of higher chord voicings, etc. We're gonna focus our attention exclusively on the bridge pickup, but I am gonna play with the tone control and we'll see what effect this has on our sound. Let's take a listen to that now. Next up, let's turn our attention to the neck pickup. We're gonna stick with the same amp sound, but this time we're gonna grab a stiff plectrum and dig in and see if we can get some of that pseudo P bass tone. Let's take a listen to that now. And last but not least, because J-style basses are quite underrated as metal basses, we're gonna throw a dark glass distortion pedal into the circuit. We're gonna go to both pickups up full, and we're gonna dig in with a heavy pick. Let's take a listen to that. So there you go guys, this has been a look at the MVJ4-66 from Modern Vintage. It is everything that we love about vintage J basses with none of the drawbacks. It has all these cool appointments, it looks tremendous in Olympic white, but it also has these reliable tuners, the heat treated neck, it has the finished peg head, which looks great, it balances well, there's no neck dive, it's not crazy heavy, it plays great from the factory thanks to the plex setup. Again, nothing not to love here. Once again, this is the MVJ4-66 from Modern Vintage. My name is Nick Jennison with Guitar Interactive, and I will see you next time.